For the mind which follows the roving senses, carries away his intellect as the wind a boat on water. The senses by nature are turbulent, and these turbulent senses carry the mind. The senses by nature are turbulent. Turbulent in the sense constantly seeking instant pleasures, and that keeps it in that state of turbulence all the time, constantly seeking instant pleasures. The roving senses means the senses that moves from object to object. It's moving. It's constantly moving. It doesn't stay with one. The senses has to necessarily move. Why the senses has to necessarily move? Because it gets bored, it gets neutralized very fast. since it gets bored very fast, since it gets neutralized very fast, it has to keep moving. So these senses, when they move, they carry the mind with it. Now he says, the senses carry the mind, the combination of the senses and the mind carry the intellect also away. Intellect also away, meaning the reasoning ability stops. The reasoning doesn't function. For which the example that they give is like the boat. The boat on water. Like a neglected boat perishes, the neglected man perishes. Neglected man means a person who has neglected his intellect. It's implied here. That's understood. He is lost because the intellect is neglected. A very famous metaphor, this boat metaphor. Most of the Vedantic texts, they use this boat metaphor because of a few parallels. Because of certain things are explained very well through this metaphor. The boat represents the individual. The boat represents the individual. The ocean is the world, samsara. The ocean stands for the world which he lives in. That's the samsara, the world. The winds, the passion. The winds is the passions of the mind. The captain, the intellect. And the captain uses the compass to reach. In and through the winds, he uses the compass to steer himself to the destination. And the compass are the shastras, the scriptures. The scriptures are the compass. When he is using the compass, he is directed well, he reaches the shore safely. The shore of immortality. He reaches the shore safely. Now imagine this. In that vast ocean, a boat without a captain and compass. The boat without a captain and compass is entirely at the mercy of the winds. Whichever way the wind blows, the boat keeps moving in that direction. Similarly, whichever way the passions of the mind drives, the individual keeps moving in that direction. In this constant tossing, it loses a direction. It loses the direction, it loses the destination. Instead of landing in one place, it will go elsewhere. Most of the time it will not land anywhere. It will be just drowned in the ocean. It will get drowned in the ocean itself. That's how they say people are lost in this world. Just as the boat is lost in the ocean, the human being is lost in this world. The winds are powerful. The winds are fierce. The ocean winds are fierce. The ocean winds are powerful. How to steer that boat? Only the captain knows. Under normal circumstances, if you look at it, a tiny boat is helpless against the, this is where the boat metaphor comparison is so wonderful. Under normal circumstances, the winds are so fierce that it looks like a tiny boat. How can it survive the fierce winds? Looks like it has to necessarily break. It has to necessarily perish. For if you know the intensity of the wind and the capacity of the boat, wind is not like this fan, no. It's not like this. This is a wind. It's toss. It's turbulent. The passions of the world are like that. So it looks like the human being has got no choice but to fall a victim to the passions. And how much ever he tries, looks like he is a failure. Just as how much ever the boat is trying to reach the shore safely, it's only getting drowned. The captain knows how to steer the boat. Only the captain knows how to steer the boat. If he has to cut through the winds, he will cut through the winds. If he has to duck under the wind, he will duck. Depending on the sea. It is the captain knows. Depending on the intensity of the wind, he knows how to steer. That is the function of the intellect. Where it has to duck, it will duck. Where it has to fight and cut through, it will fight and cut through. Where it has to take a different path, it will take a different path. But the intellect knows what it's doing and it reaches the destination. So when it is steering, what he takes guidance from? The scriptures, the shastras. The shastras are the compass. Why the compass is equated to the shastras is because the compass shows only one direction. Only one direction it shows, north. And that one direction is enough for you to know all other directions. In the Atmabodha, Shankaracharya talks about this, that just as the knowing one direction you know, you don't have to teach the human being all directions. Just showing one direction is enough. Instantly he knows everything else, he says. Just as instantly he knows everything else. You just say, this is north. That's enough. Instantly he knows what is south, what is east, what is west, what is southeast, what is northwest. I don't know what all directions are. You didn't give him all that. All that you told him is what? Just one direction. What is that? It is? It's north. One. Number two, the compass is this. Under all circumstances, it will keep pointing to one direction only. Shastras are that. Anything you go to, whatever be it, it keeps pointing to one direction. What is that? Towards self. Correct. That's all. It just shows one direction. Towards self. Here we get so frustrated. Here we get so bored. We say, why not you say something? Why can't you say something else also? Why do you have to keep repeating the same thing? The compass says, what can I do? I know only one thing. What? So it will not show all directions. So, keeping the focus on that direction, intellect understands how to steer itself in all other directions. Carefully follow. We go to shastras and we ask them to show all directions. We go to the shastras and ask them to show. What are all the directions we ask the shastras to show? How to handle wife? How to handle children? How to handle death? How to handle disease? These are all the various These are all the various directions. You can ask for all this. The compass is, by knowing this, you will know everything else. By knowing this, you will know everything else. For all this can never be taught. It can be taught, but you will come back. Okay, how to handle the partner will be taught, but then few years later you will not know how to handle the children. Then how to handle the children will be taught, and then you will not know how to handle the daughter-in-law that is going to, or the daughter-in-law that has come. You will know how to handle the daughter-in-law. Oh, nowadays grandchildren are too much to handle, sir. For straight away they say you don't know anything. That girl is telling me, 11th class, that girl, she is telling me, "Uncle, nowadays parents don't understand one thing." "What?" "The parents don't understand one thing." I said, "I am also a parent, so I also don't understand. You please teach me. You please teach me also. What is it that we all don't understand?" She is saying, "You know, uncle, our 15 year today was your 27 years. What you will know at between 25 and 30, we know at 15. Now what can you do to that child?" I say, "Correct, nothing to be discussed." I said, "You go your way, I go my way." For, you know, she is saying that today, she is telling me, and when I came back thinking maybe it is correct also. She is telling me, "You know, the parents don't understand this, uncle." I said, "No, what is it?" "What you guys knew at 25, what you guys knew between 25 and 30, we know now." Now the same child, when it look at the grandparent, what it will say? What you know at 60, we know it now. We know much more than you. Correct. And they are correct also. They know. You follow what I am saying? Oh, how to handle the grandchildren when they come and speak like this? You can keep asking one how to handle one situation after the other situation. You know how to handle that, but the next situation you will not know how to. The next one you will not know how to handle. Okay, you will know how to handle the sickness of the daughter-in-law, but when the son gets sick, you will not know how to handle that. You follow? Now when we consult the Shastras, we tell the Shastras, north direction utrungo. Leave the self temporarily. It's like telling the compass, stop showing north for a temporary period of time. Show everything else. One day we will come to north. Shastra doesn't answer the question. It only keep pointing to north. If you are wise, you will know how to handle it. You follow? That's why this boat metaphor is such a wonderful, wonderful metaphor. Since the intellect is not strong enough to consult the Shastras, scriptures, you need to borrow the intellect. Carefully follow now. Since the intellect of yours is not strong enough, you need to borrow the intellect for a temporary period of time. That intellect that you borrow from outside is the Guru. So two things. Till you strengthen your intellect, what do? You don't have to be at the mercy of the winds. You can borrow an intellect. You follow? You can borrow an intellect. That's the Guru. And what the Guru does? Again he consults the Shastras. For he has become the Shastra himself, not that he has to consult it. For he and the Shastra is one and the same. Therefore, in the initial stages, you borrow that. You need to borrow the intellect to strengthen your intellect initially. Just as you have a broken leg, you have to use the leg from outside. What is the leg from outside? The crutches that you use, the stick that you use replaces your leg. Correct? Ultimately, you have to exercise and be free from the. You have to be free from that. But till you become strong, you need to use, you need to borrow. But nevertheless, whether it is your intellect or the higher intellect, both of them follow only one thing. What? The scriptures, the shastras. And what the shastra says, there is only one thing. What? The self. Yota vera edhuvume illaya sir. Idhu vera edhavadhu, you know. Why can't we talk about something else also? Only one thing that matters in life is self. If you are not taking guidance, you are tossed by the impulses. You are tossed by the whims and the fancies. You are tossed by your own seeking results all the time. What are all the things that tosses you? You need to understand it. What are the things that keeps tossing you all the time? First thing is seeking instant happiness. The captain knows, as though he can see the intensity of the wind. He sees actually the intensity of the wind, and he steers himself, and he knows how to steer himself. Almost he seeing the winds. We all experience the wind, but we do not know how to steer. We all experience it, but we do not know how to steer ourselves. You follow? What are the winds? What are all the types of winds that you are tossed by? If you understand that, you know how to steer yourself. Huh? What are all the winds that you are tossed by? Number one, seeking instant pleasures, instant happiness. That itself is enough. You don't need anything. Yeah, that itself is enough. You don't need anything else. The second thing that does is the second thing. And I say not in that order. Just understand. All on the linear plane. Not one below the other. Instant pleasures. Second thing is the constant result orientation. Constant result orientation. Tosses you up. When you are too result oriented, you become superstitious, you become impulsive, you will go and do all sorts of things which makes you superstitious. You believe in all that, you will start becoming superstitious also. That man said during the last month lecture series, the fellow, he came and said, is it possible to have three bodies, sir? He asked me, is it possible to have three bodies? I said, yeah, gross, subtle and I said, yeah, three bodies, gross body, subtle body, causal body. No, no, sir, not that body. I knew what he was. Because suddenly if he come and ask three bodies, now that fellow is completely, he has completely become superstitious. He is completely lost. He has lost it completely. I said, yana therinja ore three bodies, gross, subtle and causal. Adhukku mela edhaavadhu irundha, I have to go and ask him only. As the teacher God, he has taught me only these things. No, no, sir. You know, my guru has three bodies. My guru has three bodies. I said, guru nale all bodies are transcended. No, why three bodies na? He is saying that he can be in Rishikesh, Hyderabad, Pune at the same time. Are you able to follow? He is saying he has three bodies. What bodies? You are sitting here, no, you are not at your, you are sitting, your thoughts might go there, but body is, gross body is only one. You are sitting here means the body is here. Now you can't be here and you can't be in San Francisco also at the same time. No? He is saying that he has three. I said, I don't know. I said, what to speak to him now? I said, I don't know. Now he is asking, is it possible to have like that? I said, for this question I can answer. I said, now I will give you an answer. Now you will go to third man. My guru has three bodies, and this man said, it is possible or not possible, and you will ask him also, what is it? You follow? Too much of, is it the what makes you superstitious? What makes you superstitious in life? Where you can't do the effort and wait. What makes you superstitious? What makes you believe in all weird things in life? You are tossed by result orientation. You are tossed by the result orientation. Anyone guarantees you of any result, there is a gate crash. Yeah. I have given this example many a time, the same example. There is a street magician walking on the road and Gautam Buddha walking on the road. Who will look attractive? The crowd will go only to the magician. For Buddha says, effort, wait, we don't know whether the fruit will come or not, but you have to only put in the effort. Here is this man saying, you don't worry, even if you don't put any effort also, don't worry, I will give you my effort. I have done effort, out of that effort I have developed a lot of energies and powers. I will give you that. You are tossed by that. Are you able to follow? Where it starts from? Result orientation. What does result orientation means? What does result orientation means? Guarantee for the fruit. You want an assurance. You want a proof. You want a guarantee. That's the second wind. Various winds tosses you all the time. The first one is instant happiness. The second thing is result. Result orientation. The third thing that tosses you, which doesn't allow you to take guidance, which doesn't allow you to take guidance. I know. The third wind. I know. This is the wind. I know. It means you don't know. Supposing you both knows now, what is there to talk? I can start confidently at 7:30. Om Sahana Votun, I can start only with the firm conviction that you don't know. Supposing you also know what all I am going to say, now what is there to talk after that? So I know, you don't know. Carefully follow. I know, you don't know. The very fact, if I am believing that you don't know, what is there to show off now? Yeah, you can show off only to those who? It's like the rich man showing off his wealth to the maid servants. Does it have any? I know, you don't know. I know, therefore I am right. You don't know, therefore you are wrong. That's all. No relationship exists between. No two human beings has any relationship at all in this world. Because it all starts with I know, you don't know. Supposing if both knows, we will be staying in silence only. Yeah, there is nothing to speak after that. Correct? I know, you don't know. It's not just that. I know. It doesn't stop there. I know, therefore I am right. You don't know, therefore you are wrong. Correct. Yeah. That's why the conversation with which we can put another down, we can belittle the other, put the other down. From where is it coming from? I know, therefore I am. You don't know, therefore wrong. அவங்களுக்கு ஒன்றும் தெரியாது சார். தே டோன்ட் தேர்ட் திங் ஐ நோ ஐ எம் ரைட் அதோட நிக்கல. இட் டசன்ட் ஸ்டாப் ஐ எம் ரைட்டோட இட் டசன்ட் ஸ்டாப் தேர். த வின்ஸ் நோ தீஸ் ஆர் ஆல் த வின்ஸ் தட் யூ ஆர் கெட்டிங் லாஸ்ட். யூ ஆர் டர்ன் இன் டு பீசஸ் பை திஸ் ஐ நோ ஐ எம் ரைட். Therefore, I am indispensable. I am very important. That is the pride. You don't know. You are wrong. You are not. All of that. You can be dispensed with. Yes. That's why you can just discard anything. You can discard anything or anyone like that. Why? Are you able to follow? I know. Since I know, I am right. Then the most righteous knowledgeable person is the most indispensable person. No, and who is that? Ah, it's me. And who are you, Mark? Correct. Who are you? You don't know. Yeah, you are wrong. Even if you give me dinner and ask the question also, you are still wrong only. You are dispensable. You follow? Another wind that tosses. These are all the very basic fabric of the ego. That's all I'm trying to explain. What are all the basic fabric of the ego which keeps you tossing up and down, and how much ever you hear, you are not able to have a grip on it. You are not able to have a control over it. You follow? How to get a grip and control, I'll come later. How the intellect will get strengthened, I'll come later. First understand the winds. What that captain has done that he is able to manage this winds is ascharya. What knowledge the captain is having that he is able to steer himself through these turbulent winds and he has reached the shore safely. What he has done, that's what we are trying to emulate. That's what we are trying to do. That's what the Shastras is all about. That's what the enlightened masters is all about. You follow? Now the winds. No, wind are not in Udala. Yeah, the winds are many. Yeah, captain or captain. Winds are different intensities, different angles, different directions. Winds are many. These are all the basic material, the basic fabric of the ego that I am talking about. Another turbulent wind. Another turbulent wind. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 8 Naam arandhiruvan list. Shankar. You have to maintain the, whenever I ask, you have to say correct number la solli varum. Maathi maathi illa. If I ask him in between, he will add his own philosophy also. Suddenly he will give some quote in Tamil now. No one will understand that also. The fourth thing, the fourth wind is the ignorance, the pride. The fourth thing is that ignorance. The ignorance. Ignorance means you see that which is not there. You don't see that which is there. That's ignorance. You see that which is not there. You don't see that which is there. Rope and the snake. You don't see the rope which is there. You see the snake which is not there. And all the questions is asked about the non-existing snake. No question is asked about the existing rope. All the question is asked about the non-existing snake. Now what to do? You follow? Ignorance. What is ignorance? Ignorance means not seeing the reality. What is the reality of life? The reality of life is this. It's impermanent. It is impermanent. Success comes. It's impermanent. Failure comes. It is impermanent. Joy comes. It's impermanent. Sorrow comes. It's impermanent. Honor comes. It's impermanent. Dishonor comes. It is impermanent. Is there anything in life that you can call it as permanent? There is nothing. But you see something as permanent. That's what ignorance is. You see that which is not there. I'm not talking about God and all. You forget about divinity. Divinity comes at the later stage. First learn to see the reality. What is the reality? It is impermanent. What is impermanent? All the experiences of life is impermanent. Infancy comes. It is impermanent. See, after the class, don't get up now and see. After the class, see. When Vatsala Mami walks through after the class, don't get up now. Yaar theriyilena, I'll show you after the class. When she walks through, it's impossible to believe that she was an infant once, no? It's impossible to believe that she was an infant once. Ipo evlo 80, yeah? Cross 80. Impossible. Infancy comes, but it is impermanent. Teenage comes, it is permanent. Youthhood comes, it is impermanent. Old age comes, it is impermanent. Birth happens, it is impermanent. impermanent. Death happens, it is. So everything in life is impermanent. But you see something as permanent. How do you give a permanency to that which is impermanent? Again I repeat, again I am asking the question, follow the question. How do you, even though theoretically you understand everything is impermanent, one by one you take and analyze, all are impermanent. But when all these impermanent factors get together, the quality changes, the property changes, and it becomes, and it gives you a notion of permanency. What is it that you are doing that makes you to see the impermanent as permanent? Ignorance. What is it that you are doing in ignorance that the impermanent looks permanent? What is it that you are doing? By paying attention to it. Anything you pay attention to, it becomes permanent. Someone passed a remark about you 40 years back. That fellow who passed the remark is also dead and gone. But you still, you are still affected by it. Because of what? You pay attention to it. You follow? By paying attention to anything, the impermanent becomes permanent. Success comes, don't pay attention to it, keep moving. Failure comes, don't pay attention to it, keep moving. You follow? The fourth wind that you are tossed by is the sense of permanency that you give to everything. Everything you give it a sense of permanency, even though theoretically you understand it is all. Even though theoretically you can understand it as impermanent, even though you can tell someone else or you can tell the whole world that it is impermanent. Like the doctor was asking me, she was so sweet, she is telling me, sir, how many parents I have given advice, how many parents I have given counseling to. She has a girl, 16 year old girl will fall in love with someone else. If she say take me to Bhagavad Gita class, there is something fundamentally wrong with that girl. And if that girl is falling in love with the boy, now it is she is saying, just to irritate her, she said, lighten up. She said, no, my girl has fallen in love. I said, okay, boy or girl? That's the first thing. Is it a boy or is it a girl? Because boy can fall in love with boy, girl can fall in love with girl today. So we really don't know whether, if they say we are in love, first thing let us make clear, boy or girl. Next application, just to, otherwise, she is telling me, I can't believe that I am asking you this question, sir. For how many parents I have counseled. What is the counseling? It's hormones, it's age. How many times I have given all this counseling? But to my daughter I am not able to, even though I understand all this, in and through all that, I am still turbulent. I don't know what to do. What do I do to her? Are you able to follow? You understand everything, but when it comes to your own self, why are you not able to understand? You have paid attention in the wrong way. You have fixed attention in the wrong way. What is the wrong way in which you have fixed attention? You have fixed your attention in the wrong way. Otherwise, the doctor is telling me, I don't know, I am going to speak to the doctor today. When I am going to speak to that girl, I don't know. The daughter is going to come and meet me. And if the parents were to hear what I am going to tell the daughter, they will not come back. They will not come back again. You follow? In what is the wrong way in which you are paying attention to? As a result of which the impermanent has become permanent. First is stage number one of ignorance. Follow? Impermanent has become permanent. By what? By you fixing attention. And you are fixing attention in one particular way, which is the wrong way. In what way you are fixing attention, as a result of which the impermanent has become permanent and you are affected by it, even though you know, even though you understand all that. What is that? I can't hear. My, correct. My, mindness. The another wing. You follow? The mindness. My daughter. Wherever you fix your attention on mind, whatever you call as mind, wherever you fix your attention on mind, take it or leave it, your downfall is in that only. You might agree, you might not agree, but your downfall comes in that only. Remember that. You have 200 things calling as mind. No. 200 ways of downfall. It doesn't matter whether one or many. Whatsoever you understand as mind, whatsoever you call as mind, wherever you have fixed your attention as mind, your downfall comes from that only, not from anything else. So when you fix your attention upon something calling as mind, you don't know what you are doing. You are asking for your own downfall. That's why the Vedanta says, the knowledge says, you have an obligation to do, but you can't call it as mind. Obligations you have, but mindness you can't. But your point is, the mindness on that is an obligation. Correct? Unless you call as mind, where is the obligation itself? You follow? The fabrics of what are all the winds that causes you permanent. What is impermanent? You give up permanency. How you give up permanency? My success. I have attained my. You follow? I and my failure. That's it. I can never bounce back again. You follow? Wherever you have claim, wherever you say this is mine, your downfall is in that only. Not from anything else. And you have enough things to say, mine, and those things looks permanent. And if the impermanency, if you have the experience of impermanency, you come back saying, I am agitated, I am disturbed, I don't know what to do. Take it like this, it's very simple. The person loving you today need not love you tomorrow. That's all. The person loving you today need not love you tomorrow. There is no no problem. But then the person loving you today has to love you tomorrow and forever. Yeah. Next janma lo kuda we should be together, huh? Next janma lo kuda. In this janma itself is too much to in this janma is too much to handle. Why another janma? You follow? The fixation means you have given permanency. Affectation means you have given permanency. Health comes, it's impermanent. Disease comes, again it is permanent. When you give permanency to something which is impermanent by nature, you will be lost in that. That's how the Shastra says everyone is lost in this world. And when the enlightened master says you are all lost in this world, we get very annoyed. Why are they talking with such arrogance? They don't have any humility. What? Who? Long back, one of the close persons in our family, everyone thought he is a very philosophical person. Even today, they all think he is more philosophical than me. He is very so. He was asking me, you know, Gita lam padikira, this, that. So he said, what do I read? Give me one book. So I gave one Ramatirtha volume. I said, read this volume 1. He read for 2 weeks. He came back and said, no, his analysis and all that is very good, but he is very arrogant also. Why? Because he keeps on saying, Rama says so. Humility, what a pecker love. If you follow, who? Ramatirtha has to learn humility from? Ramatirtha has to learn humility from this man now. Just as you also believe, you also have something to teach Shankaracharya, no? You also believe, no? He has articulated it. Rest don't articulate. That's all. But everyone has to. You pay attention. What is it that you pay attention to? By claiming something as mine, that impermanent becomes. You hope that to be permanent. You hope it remains permanent. Carefully follow. Permanency is your hope. The reality is impermanent. Correct? Like this. The permanency is your hope. What is the reality? Impermanent. And when you encounter the reality, you get affected. You come back and say, why life is cruel? Why life is unfair? Why only me? Anga kuda me na, illaya? Sir, please help. No, just as I am suffering, everyone is suffering. You can't say that also. Even there, you have to claim exclusive ownership on suffering. What is that? Why only me when everyone else is happy? And I ask, what makes you to believe everyone else is happy? No, you say you are unhappy, but what makes you to believe others are happy? They are all going shopping. They are all watching movies. They are all buying clothes. They are all going on a holiday. Therefore, they are all happy. But you are also doing the same thing, no? What is it that you are not doing in this? You are also following the thing. The winds that causes you. Inala winds is on that? Santas. I know he is lost, that's why he asked me. His eye suddenly popped up. He lost. Story is like he is lost. Ramesh Khanna. What are all the winds? You are making a list, no? You are not making. No one is making the list. This is detachment. Only thing is, in the detachment, well, practice pannu. The detachment is practiced in the class. To the class, detachment is. Solunga. Correct. Ignorance.
I know.
Third is I know. Ignorance. What is ignorance? Where the reality is, it is impermanent, you have a hope of permanency. That's ignorance. This tosses you. Are you able to follow how each and everything in itself has the potency to completely destroy you, and you are a victim of mark. Very depressing. Very depressing now. Very depressing. How to do that? Now comes the solution. Now comes how the what the intellect has done, what the intellect does, that it knows how to steer itself through these turbulences. Otherwise, it looks like you have to perish only. Ella keka nalla irukku sir, but you will you will perish only. Yes. That is permanency. That is permanency. Security. Correct. Security. All the time you are seeking security. Where lies security? If something is permanent, it becomes secure. That's why you hold on to it. Because it's going to save you. It's going to protect you. If you understand that as impermanent, can you ever find security out of it? It is through permanency. Wealth you hold on to. For what? Security. That's all. Security means what? Philosophically. Permanency. That's why, Abba, I have kept enough provisions right up to my grandchildren. Permanency. It's going to be like that. You follow what I am saying? It's going to be like that. Supposing next week, tomorrow, the whole thing might change. And the whole lot can become bankrupt. What happens? You follow? It all, philosophically, it boils down to permanence. It's all permanence. You follow? You have something. Yes. Yes. The permanency and impermanency is related to time. It is related to time. That's why I said, anything you fix attention upon, you pay your attention upon, longer the time of attention, more real it looks. It's time. That's why I gave this example. No? Someone said a remark 40 years back and that fellow is dead and gone, but you are still affected by it, means that 40 years is not 40 years. It's still there. Meaning what? You got into, you are trying to keep the moving time stable. Permanency. It's time. It keeps moving. That fellow who passed the remark yesterday, it's over. Today you go and meet him, another fresh round of abuses. Yeah, another fresh round. You are happy with it, for you don't carry anything from yesterday. You carry anything from yesterday, last week, previous week, 10 years back. You carry all that. That person need not say anything. The thought of that person itself is enough. Even before the person opens his mouth, it's enough. You are irritated. It's time. Permanency is related to time. That's why the definition of time itself is change. Because time gives us a wrong sense of permanency. Whereas the truth is, it is impermanent. Impermanent means it's changing constantly. Impermanent means it's changing constantly. Number two, impermanent means it has a temporary reality. It exists as long as you pay attention to it. Sorrow exists as long as you pay attention to it. For a death that happened 50 years back, you can still mourn today. Are you able to follow? It has a temporary reality. Why do we call it as temporary reality? What gives the temporary reality? The duration with which you are paying attention. That's the time. The duration with which you are paying attention to. That's where George Bernard Shaw came and said, "My tailor." Who's the wise man? He said, My tailor. Why? He takes fresh measurements. Meaning, he doesn't carry forward the past into the... He doesn't carry forward. You follow? When you say something is impermanent, it has a temporary reality. The snake has a temporary reality. And what is the longevity of the snake? As long as you keep seeing it. But the snake is very 100 years, sir, that snake is. Now you have been seeing it for 100 years. Short lived, you are able to follow? That's all it is. You give permanency by paying attention to it. That's why they say, 25 years I have served. You have paid attention. You have served, that's it. Why 25 years or 25 seconds or 25 days? It doesn't make any. You follow? Permanency means the longevity is given by the duration of your attention. These are all the... Is it okay? Bharat. These are all the winds that... These are all the winds that tosses you up. And you are a victim of these winds. How do you... What the intellect does, it knows how to steer itself through that. In the initial stages, when you borrow an intellect from a wise man, what that wise man has done, that he reached the shore safely. What he has done, number one, taken the shastras as the authority. If you are not taking shastras as your authority, what are you taking authority as? Your own likes and dislikes. Your own whims and fancies. Your own likes and dislikes. That's why even when we go to God to satisfy our that God has to satisfy our whims and fancies. He has to satisfy our likes and dislikes. Atheist turning into theist. There are theists who turns into atheists. You know that, no? There are believers of God also turn into atheists. It means what? It means what? That belief is not? That belief is not a conviction. That belief is not backed by knowledge. That belief is a hope. That belief is a hope. What is the hope? God will satisfy my, God will answer my prayer. God will make sure that He will be a 24/7 watchman protecting all that I call as mine. Or edathile if he makes a mistake, na, that is enough. Atheist turning into theist. Theist turning into atheist. Even here if you look at it, that is also impermanent. Yeah, that is also impermanent. Even the gods and goddesses that we worship are also impermanent. That's why every few years gods also keep changing. New gods have to come to keep us entertained. Yeah. Same God night is very it's very very boring. I remember during the school time there was this goddess. She was very famous for a few years. She was very famous. She was famous for a few years. She was so famous, and everyone in every house they will be doing that. Santoshi. Today no one even knows where she is. Poor thing. Somewhere she is still existing. It keeps. After her came Satyanarayana. Everyone was doing. After that came Maruti. Suddenly Maruti became. Comics alone started coming also. Now after a while something else will come. Even the gods and goddesses that we worship also falls under the same law of life. What? Impermanent. Correct? That's why they also keep changing. What this intellect has done, that it has known the art, had the courage to steer itself through the winds and reach the shore safely. What it has done? One, it consulted the Purmonganiva Sarvashaha. Each and every verse connect back to that original question. Then you are following the sequence. What is the original question of Arjuna? Verse number 54. How does he act? How does he sit? Shankar, we are studying Bhagavad Gita, chapter 2, Stita Prajna portion. Arjuna asked a question in verse number, because Arjuna asked this question, I don't know, 3 years back he asked this question, and we forgot. He asked a question. What is the question? How does he contact? Kurmonganiva Sarvashaha. Like the Kurma, he says. Like the tortoise. He has done all that. As a result of which he is able to steer himself. First thing, consult the Shastras. Second thing, what? Fixation. Second thing is fixation. The turbulent senses and the turbulent mind needs a fixation. A goal, a fixation. fixation means that one and that's it. You die for it, but you will not change. That is called fixation. Mandodari had that fixation. Mandodari had that fixation on. That's why she is also as virtuous as Sita. If Sita is virtuous woman, now Mandodari is also equally virtuous. Mandodari is the wife of Ravana. Sita is the wife of Rama. And you have a husband like Rama, no? What is the difficulty in being a Sita? It's very easy. You have a husband like Ravana, who is running behind? Each and every sari that he sees on the roadside, he is running. He is chasing that. He is running behind that. That's Ravana, no? That's the Ravana. And Mandodari, that's the fixation. You follow? Mandodari said, you are chasing, you are running, na? That's your problem. I am fixed. You chase, na? No. Now the condition for fixation that you have is what? If you are fixed on me, then I will be fixed on you. If you go away, then it's not fixation. It's a mutual. Therefore, you have to constantly spy on each other. Are they doing this? Why are they doing that? You follow? What is fixation means? You follow? Fixation. In everything, not only the partner, no? Not only the partner, the barber, fixation. The same grocery shop you go, again and again, again. But ore kallu mannuma irukudhu, it's okay. But still go. Yeah, still go there only. But there, you follow? First thing is the intellect consulting the shastras. Second thing is the fixation. Fixation challenges your likes and dislikes. Fixation is the way to encounter your likes and dislikes directly. Otherwise, you will never encounter your likes and dislikes directly. You will be a victim of it, you will be tossed by it, and you will never know it. How to encounter your likes and dislikes directly? Fixation. What is the fixation? Something you get fixed on. God. Supposing you are fixed on God, na? After that life becomes very... very simple. Disease has come. God's prasad. You don't cry. Success has come. It is God's prasad. Fixation. After that, the moment you get into a fixation, then you know how you are a victim of your likes and dislikes. And the mind in you will never allow you to get into a fixation. It will always say, change. Second opinion, third opinion. Please take, I am not saying don't take. You take the 100 opinion also. You take, doesn't matter, take. Get into a Ananya Chinta. Ananya Sintayanto Mamyajana Adyupasate Esham Nityabhiyuktana Yogakshemam Ahamyaham. What is that method? Ananya. Ananya Chinta. That one. It's not about the quality of that one. It is about the fixation that you have. It's not the fixation, or it's not because of Rama that Sita got fixed. It's not because of Ravana that Mandodari got fixation. Is this fixation is this nature independent of the other? Are you able to follow what fixation is? Independent of the other. That's why Mandodari will teach you more than Mandodari can teach you slightly more than what Sita can teach you. At least in my opinion, don't go and say Mandodari is better than. I am not saying that. அது இன்னைக்கு ராம் நவமி வேற இல்ல தப்பா சொல்லக்கூடாது அன்னைக்கு சீதா அது ராமா வில் கெட் ஆங்கிரியா ஃபிக்சேஷன் வாட் இஸ் த ஃபிக்சேஷன் த மொமெண்ட் வி டாக் அபவுட் ஃபிக்சேஷன் வி இன்ஸ்டன்ட்லி வரி அபவுட் த குவாலிட்டி ஆஃப் த வி ஆர் சோ கன்சர்ன்ட் அபவுட் த குவாலிட்டி ஆஃப் த அதர் டு கெட் ஃபிக்ஸ்ட் ஆர் ஏபிள் டு ஃபாலோ நல்லவங்களா இருந்தா ஃபிக்ஸ் ஆகும் இல்ல சார் இன்கேஸ் இஃப் இஸ் எ சீட் இன்கேஸ் இஃப் தே டூ திஸ் இன்கேஸ் இஃப் தே டூ தட் ஃபிக்சேஷன் இஸ் யுவர் கன்விக்ஷன் இட் ஹாஸ் காட் நத்திங் டு டூ வித் தி அதர் இஃப் இட் ஹாஸ் காட் சம்திங் டு டூ வித் தி அதர்னா நோ ஒன் கேன் அட்டைன் No one can get a fixation. For you can find a flaw in anybody. You can find a flaw everywhere. You can find it. Therefore, what is fixation? It has got nothing to do with the other. It has got nothing to do with the external. It's the strength of your character. Fixation is the strength of your character. Mandodari said. Mandodari almost she didn't say it in the way, but she said it indirectly to Ravana. What? You do what you like. That is your problem. From my side, I am fixed. You follow? This fixation makes you encounter the intensity of your likes and dislikes. Unless you encounter the intensity of your likes and dislikes, you can never handle it. You will never know it. You will never know what you are fighting. You will never know what you have to overcome. If you have to fight something, you have to overcome that, you need to know the intensity. How do you know the intensity? Get into a fixation. The moment you get into a fixation, after that, do not waver. You pay the price by, you die for it, but you will not. That's why in this culture there is no such thing called divorce at all. You only get married. You don't. There's no such thing called divorce. You follow? Why? But that person is being unfaithful to me. Oh, but that person has lost his head and become unmatta, he has become mad. Should I be stuck with a mad man, mad person? The answer is what? Yes. You become strong. For you have encountered it directly. Opposite of that is what? Opposite of that is? Go on changing means running away. It's not changing. You use the word changing and you cover it up. You use the word changing and you give it a moral coloring. You give it a good coloring. What is it? You are running away. You are running away. Every change means you are running away. What is running away from what? Running away from the obligations. Running away from what? Running away from obligations. Otherwise, you are putting conditions to obligations. If you are faithful, then I will serve you. If you are this, then I will do. If you are this, then I will do. You follow? We go to God also and say the same thing. If you take care of me, I will do Sahasranama. If you don't take care of me, instead of Sahasranama, 1000 abuses will come. You follow? This, wherever we go, we go with the same thing. What is that? How this man has become so wise, so strong, that nothing is disturbing him. Nothing is affecting him. Got into a fixation. For that fixation, you have to fight the whole world. You have to fight the entire planet for that. And you need enormous strength, enormous courage. You follow? First thing is constantly consulting the Shastras. And what the Shastra says, get into a fixation. Number two, after getting into a fixation, don't waver. Die. If your fixation is, carefully follow the law, this is the law of life. If your fixation is genuine, if your fixation is correct, you will evolve. You will evolve. It has got nothing to do with the other person. You follow? You will keep evolving independent of the other. Otherwise, you are so concerned about the quality of the other person. Otherwise, we are all the time concerned about the quality of the other person. And what quality you will be concerned about? Is he fulfilling your likes and dislikes? Is he giving you a guarantee of the result? Is he giving you a hope of permanency? You go back to all the wins. Go back to the wins. Somewhere down the line you are asking only for that. What is fixation? Irrespective of whatever happens, you are fixed. But that is being very stubborn, no sir. That is being very pig-headed. No, we should be liberal, no, in life. If you say be liberal, na, you will go and get fixed in the wrong area. If you say get fixed in the right area, you will say we should be liberal and not be fanatic. One thing you will do, what? You will keep constantly arguing against. You will keep constantly arguing against the Shastras, correct. Constantly argue against the Shastras. But adala andha kaalathukku vena okay sir, indha kaalathukku idella seri poduma. As though at that time they were all even, people in the past were attached, people in the present is also attached, people in the future also will be attached. You follow what I am saying? Ergo, the Shastras constantly keep pointing out to what? Constantly pointing out to get fixed. Get fixed. Do not waver. Number three, pay the price. What is the price you pay? Death is the price you have to pay. Even if it is the price that you have to pay. For your growth lies, For your growth lies in that. You follow? Last thing that the Shastras does is, this I will take up fresh next class. Remind me,
Otherwise, after one, I will say something else.
Last thing is surrender. Faith. Surrender. That I know will not allow you to surrender. Even though you have heard any number of times about surrender, the I know will not allow you to. What does surrender means? What does surrender means? If you want to know what surrender is, read that poem, Casablanca. The boy stood on the burning. The boy stood on the burning deck. Say, father, say, is my task done? No voice, for the father is already. Father is already dead, for he is already burnt alive, and the flames are, the flames are eating that boy up bit by bit, and still that boy stood on the burning. The boy stood on the burning deck, asking this. Say, father, say, is my task done? The winds whisper, he says. The poem concludes. The winds whisper about what? About the glory of the boy. The winds whisper. The devas talk about it. The gods talk about it. What? The unwavering faith. Conviction. See, it is that conviction. You follow? Brings about it. It brings about this. All this happens because of one repeated practice they did. One repeated practice. What is that repeated practice they do? Manana, reflection. One repeated practice that fortified conviction. One repeated practice that fortified the faith, the belief, all that. What is that one practice? Manana, reflection. There are two ways of reading. There are two types of reading. One is reading like a newspaper. The newspaper reading means you can't read the same newspaper again. Correct? You don't read Shastras like that. This book I have finished. What is the next book? You don't read Shastras like that. You follow? You don't read Shastras like how you read? Newspaper. Yeah, what is newspaper reading? You can't read the same newspaper twice. Number two, the newspaper has to give variety. Number three, newspapers are so attractive because negativities are in it more than. Why are they attractive? Why are they attractive? Negativities are attractive. Somewhere a 6-year-old girl was raped by a 22-year-old insane man. News, front page news. You read that every day, you keep reading that. Every day you keep hearing news like that. 10th day you will think, what? 10th day what you will understand? 10th day what you will think? World is full of rapists. World is full of cheaters. World is full of. Because of what? Again and again and again, what are you reading? Negativities. You don't read Shastras like that. That's why one book and that's it. You go through it again and again. Mananat prayate. That which you repeat again and again and again. Not the variety. Again, what gives satisfaction is the. You follow? what this person have done so that they are able to face the turbulent winds. What are all the winds? I explained. What practices that the wise men did so that they are able to face it. So that they are able to face it and safely reached the shore. What is the shore? The shore of from turbulence, from the mortality to immortality. Sariya? Okay.
Thank you.